If one thing is clear in Steven Universe, it is that gems are extremely different from human beings. But they may be more different than originally thought, and with the variety of evidence taken into account, we might have to change the way we see gems as species. In fact, we can go as far as to say that gems are actually artificial intelligence and not natural beings at all. Hello everyone, this is Eve, your narrator for this video. To begin, let's talk about the most logical gem candidate to be a form of artificial intelligence, or AI, Pearl. From what Peridot told us in Back to the Barn, Pearl is nothing more than a fancy accessory. We learned that Pearls are servants who are not supposed to have a free will of their own. They were probably made to order based on their owner's specifications, and we know that a Peridot could never own a Pearl, so Pearls were most likely reserved only for highest ranking gems. However, it has become clear that the Pearl we know and love is not like the rest of her kind, although she still has some of the mannerisms of being a servant, as she does most of the cleaning and building we have seen in the show. Yet, Pearl goes way beyond what she was built for, and other gems have noticed this. This goes back to when Jasper called Pearl defective, which was talked about in a previous theory video. But to return to the topic of artificial intelligence, Pearls would be more likely than other gems to be AI simply because they are mass-produced and are able to adapt when necessary. So it may be true that Pearls have artificial intelligence, but what about the gem species as a whole? Looking at a whole other set of evidence, there is so much that can be said about what gems really are. If gems were able to reproduce naturally, then it would not be as easy to call them artificial intelligence. However, they are only created from injectors that use the raw materials within planets. This destroys the planet in the process, unfortunately. To counter this, perhaps the only place where they produce naturally is on their homeworld, but that process may have been too slow to satisfy some of the gems, so they went to other planets and took its resources via the virus-like drills. The new gems they made may have been different from the natural ones, and told by their creators that they were programmed to do certain things. But that's purely speculation, and the evidence that gems can only be created in one way is much more convincing as of now. In addition, gems are said to not be organic, and the gem on their body is all that they really are. Truly, their bodies are only an illusion, projections generated from their gemstone.
Think of it like a hologram, but with mass.
Nice mass!
I know.
The way they are created is extremely different from that of a human, but the differences are nowhere close to ending there. Gems don't age, and seem to be able to live forever until their gem is severely cracked or broken. The materials their physical form is made up of is completely different from that of a human. For the most part, their physical form is only made up of energy projected from their gemstone, as stated earlier. But when a gem is severely damaged, we can see that they have circuit-like patterns on their skin. Even Steven, the half-gem, half-human hybrid, has these markings beneath his skin. And when they become damaged or corrupted, they glitch out and their physical forms can take on drastic changes. All of these things point to gems being something totally inorganic. They run in some sort of programming that contains loads of information instead of DNA that can change and adapt over time. If the gems are made of artificial intelligence, then they are unlike anything we have seen before in real life. They are extremely smart, can solve problems, and have ideas way beyond anything current programs can do. They can even power other devices, showing that their gem can hold immense levels of power. Yet, if they are AI, then there's still this huge question of who created gems and the injectors in the first place. Of course, there's no way we can answer that now, but it's very likely that they are no longer around. One theory is that the gems destroyed their creators long ago, as they were smart enough to know that they should no longer be treated as servants. However, if their creators are still around, gems may still simply be servants, which have their own hierarchy. We will have to keep watching the show to see if it's ever addressed how gems came into existence, and if they really are artificial intelligence or not. Thank you for watching.
One last thing before we end this theory video. There's this cool competition this company called WayUp is doing called the College Box. Basically, if you get 20 people to join WayUp, you get a box full of awesome goodies, and I would love to try and get it to unbox it for you guys on my other channel. This is a website for anyone in college that needs a part-time job, internship, or a full-time job if you're a senior. I signed up recently and it's very easy to do so. I have decided if I can get 100 people to join it, I will do a big seniors giveaway. Even if you aren't in college but know someone that is, ask them to use this link to sign up. I'll put my referral link below so you can sign up and help me towards my goal. I also made a video about it on my other channel. Tell me if you or anyone else you know signed up. Thank you so much.
Hi guys, just reminding you all of Cartoon Universe's Patreon. They got loads of cool rewards for different pledges, so you should all go check it out. Like I did. Go check it out. It's worth it. I did it. You should definitely do it, please. Yes, thank you.